I'm the person that your mom was listening to while she was driving you to school. You know, I started when I was 17, and I got my first record deal when I was 17, and first album released when I was 19, and now 7 albums later, I'm back with Passion Like Fire, and I'm really excited about it. The first single was Leave It Smokin', and getting ready to go on tour. And so if you don't know me or my music, definitely come out and see me on tour. We have a great time. So Passion Like Fire is my 7th album. And like I said, the first album was when I was 19. So obviously some things have changed. And hopefully from this project, from now to the previous projects, you've been able to see growth and vocal growth, obviously maturity. But I still try to sing about love and relationships and personal growth, because those are the things that speak to me. So I think there are some things that are different, like I said, vocal arrangements and things like that, but some things are the same as the beginning. I've always sung about relationships and growth and you know, different aspects of that. Love is always my inspiration, and love, loss, and heartache, and you know, there, love is many things. And so I think, just like relationships, there, whether it's with, you know, your significant other or someone you're dating or your children, I mean, relationships can be complicated, but when you work at them and when they work, they're amazing. And so this, you know, Passion Like Fire is the same. It's based around love. So the first single was on this latest project, Passion Like Fire, is Leave It Smokin'. And I collaborated again with a good friend of mine, Salam Remy. We did a song, Beautiful Surprise, together off my last project. And he's so amazing. And we went to Miami, recorded, you know, did this song, and love it. And then recently we did a remix with Wale, and it was so much fun to hear him on the record and doing his thing. You know, I think he brought sort of a fresh perspective to it, which was great. You know, there's a certain type of, you know, sound, type of thinking sort of that I wanted around this song, and you know, he was top of the list. Here's the amazing thing about, you know, my catalog, and you know, I've been super fortunate to be around for a while, and you know, what's happening now is that you're seeing artists, like I'm celebrating like 20 years of, you know, So Into You. So you're seeing younger artists now singing, you know, So Into You and things like that. So they're being brought to the music from the people they're listening to, and they're referencing my music. So it's been really great just seeing sort of, you know, the impact that you have on other musicians, and they have on me as well. I still have all of the memories of being in the studio, and Quincy Jones was there, and Greg Fillinganes, and you know, Tim and Bob, and you know, they brought this amazing song, and you know, I helped write it with them. So when I hear So Into You, I immediately go back to that. And you know, then yeah, it had another chance with Fabulous, and you know, it's been, you know, like I said, other artists have done it, you know, Childish Gambino and all of that. So it's great hearing other people's, you know, interpretation of something that you wrote, whether it's, you know, You Are Loved, which is like a personal message from me to the fans, or Leave It Smoking, having a good time, hanging with your friends, no drama. You, as an artist, you just hope that the music connects with people and that they feel something.